Hi everyone, today in this video we are going to discuss about dulaglutide. What is this drug dulaglutide? The suffix glutide indicates this drug is an incretin mimetic. So dulaglutide is a glucagon like peptide 1 receptor agonist, commonly known as GLP-1 agonist. This drug can be used in the treatment of type 2 diabetes along with diet and exercise in order to control the glucose levels. And particularly this drug can produce better glycemic control because the type 2 diabetes mellitus is associated with many of the macrovascular as well as microvascular complications. Among these, one of the important complications is the cardiovascular complications associated with type 2 diabetes mellitus. For example, stroke, heart failure and acute coronary syndrome may be associated with type 2 diabetes mellitus, which are fatal to the patient. So these cardiovascular complications can be minimized by this GLP-1 agonist. So dulaglutide can reduce the cardiovascular complications associated with type 2 diabetes mellitus. Particularly this drug is a incretin mimetic, so it acts like incretin. But one of the advantages of this drug is long-acting GLP-1 agonist. So there is no need to give this drug every day. This drug is administered once a weekly. So because of long duration of action, it can control the glucose levels for the entire week. And it can reduce the fasting blood glucose levels as well as postprandial blood glucose levels. So what are the blood glucose levels during the fasting conditions as well as after the fed conditions can be controlled by dulaglutide. So today in this video, we are going to discuss about this dulaglutide, how this drug acts, what are the important precautions, side effects, contraindications. We will discuss in this video. First of all, let us see the chemical nature of this drug. So what is this drug dulaglutide? This drug is a protein and it is made up of rDNA technology, and this drug is resembling human GLP-1 up to 90%. So it just acts like the human GLP-1. That's why it is called as incretin mimetic. Here the fragment of GLP-1 is going to be attached to the Fc binding site of IgG4. So this is the Fc component of human IgG4, immunoglobulin G4. To this, a small linking peptide is going to be incorporated, which is attached with the GLP-1 fragment. The N-terminal of GLP-1 is going to be attached here, and this entire structure is nothing but dulaglutide. Now, because of structural similarity with the GLP-1, this can act as incretin and it can reduce both fasting blood glucose levels as well as postprandial blood glucose levels. Now let us see how this drug acts. Dulaglutide is going to control the glucose levels by different mechanisms. One of the primary site of action of this drug is on the pancreas. It can act on the beta cells of the pancreas to stimulate the glucose dependent insulin release, and it can also act on the alpha cells to reduce the glucagon release. So insulin release is promoted and glucagon release is going to be inhibited by this dulaglutide. And it can also act on the stomach and it can reduce the gastric emptying. So delay in the gastric emptying reduce the glucose absorption. The effect on gastric emptying is because of its inhibitory effect on vagus nerve. Similarly, this dulaglutide can also act on the brain and it can reduce the appetite, which results in the weight loss in the patients. So this is the beta cells of pancreas, which are expressed with GLP-1 receptors, glucagon like peptide 1 receptors. These are G protein coupled receptors, which are stimulatory in nature. They are coupled with alpha, beta, gamma subunits. Now this dulaglutide can act on these GLP-1 receptors. When this dulaglutide binds to these receptors, they are activated such that they stimulate adenylyl cyclase system. This adenylyl cyclase can convert the ATP into one of the important secondary messenger, cyclic AMP. Now this cyclic AMP can stimulate the protein kinase A, and it can also stimulate EPAC, another binding protein for cyclic AMP. This EPAC is mainly responsible for gene transcription proliferation, and protein kinase A can control the intracellular calcium levels. So this protein kinase A can stimulate the inward going calcium channels. Now calcium can enter into the cells, which produce the depolarization of the beta cells, thereby can promote the exocytosis and release of the insulin. In this way, insulin is going to be released by the action of dulaglutide on GLP-1 receptors. Similarly, dulaglutide can also reduce the glucagon release by acting on the alpha cells. All these actions, along with delay in the gastric emptying, reduce the glucose levels. And since this drug is a long acting, this drug can be given once a weekly to control the glucose levels. What are the important precautions? One of the important precautions of dulaglutide is that this drug can produce some gastrointestinal side effects. So within the patients, we can observe few of the gastrointestinal disturbances such as constipation, flatulence, abdominal distension, eructation, expulsion of gases through the mouth, and gastroesophageal reflex can also be observed. So all these side effects are associated with the dulaglutide. Similarly, this drug can also affect the pancreas because its side of action is the pancreas, and this drug can produce some pancreatitis. So this drug can produce abdominal pain, weight loss, nausea and vomiting, as well as diarrhea in the patients. So if any of these symptoms are observed, then this drug should be stopped and replaced with alternative agent. Similarly, this drug can produce some acute renal failure in the patients. Particularly, nausea and vomiting, diarrhea produced by this drug can further complicate this acute renal failure. So care should be taken to check any renal functionality. And very importantly, this drug can induce thyroid C-cell adenoma and carcinoma. So this is another important precaution that should be monitored. So this drug can produce some thyroid cancer. So C-cell adenoma and carcinoma may be developed after the use of dulaglutide for long-term treatment. Another important precaution of this drug is the hypersensitivity. So this drug can produce some urticaria, facial edema, skin rashes, swelling of the lips can be observed. So care should be taken to monitor any hypersensitive reactions produced in the patients. Just like with other drugs, dulaglutide can also produce hypoglycemia because it is going to reduce the glucose levels. But when this drug is combined with other drugs like sulfonylureas can also increase the glucose release from the beta cells. So we have few of the drugs like glipizide, glibenclamide. So if these drugs are combined with dulaglutide, they can further increase the hypoglycemia. So severe hypoglycemia may be produced by this drug combination. What are the side effects? Many of the side effects of dulaglutide are related with the gastrointestinal system. So this drug can produce nausea and vomiting, abdominal pain, loss of appetite, dyspepsia, fatigue, asthenia, lack of energy, malaise, some discomfort, hypoglycemia. Particularly this hypoglycemia is observed when other antidiabetic agents are added. Similarly, this drug can also increase the heart rate, resulting in that sinus tachycardia, some hypersensitive reactions like urticaria, facial edema, skin rashes, and swelling of lips can be observed with this dulaglutide. What are the contraindications? This drug is contraindicated in two important conditions. First one, it is contraindicated in medullary thyroid carcinoma, MTC, because this drug can increase the thyroid cancer, so it is contraindicated in medullary thyroid carcinoma. Similarly, it is contraindicated in multi-endocrine neoplasia syndrome type 2, commonly known as MEN2. So both of these disorders may be increased by dulaglutide because this dulaglutide can produce some thyroid cancer. So in such patients, this drug is strictly contraindicated. How it is given? This drug is given by injection and it is available as pen model and pre-filled injection. It is available at two strengths such as 0.75 mg per 0.5 ml, otherwise 1.5 mg per 0.5 ml. The initial dose of this dulaglutide is given at 0.75 mg once a week. So started with a low dose, and based on the efficacy of the treatment, the dose may be increased up to 1.5 mg once a week. So the maximum dose is the 1.5 mg which is given once a week. So that's about this dulaglutide. Dulaglutide is a long-acting GLP-1 receptor agonist. It is also called as incretin mimetic because it is going to increase the action of GLP-1, glucagon-like peptide-1. This drug can reduce fasting blood glucose levels as well as postprandial blood glucose levels. So along with diet and exercise, this drug can be given in the type 2 diabetes mellitus, where it can reduce the cardiovascular complications. But this drug may produce thyroid C-cell carcinoma. So care should be taken to monitor any development of carcinoma in the patients. And this drug can also produce hypoglycemia and pancreatitis. Similarly, this drug can produce gastrointestinal side effects such as abdominal pain, abdominal distension, gastroesophageal reflux and constipation. Particularly in the thyroid cancer and multi-endocrinal neoplasia, this drug is contraindicated. This drug is given at an initial dose of 0.75 mg once a week, but the maximum dose is 1.5 mg once a week. So that's about this drug, Dulaglutide. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.